This video is going to take you through the basics of a potential energy diagram. I'm not going to put any numbers in this video. The next video, the more advanced one, we're going to actually do numbers. Potential energy diagram just shows you the potential energy change that happens during a reaction going from the reactants to the products and how it changes over time. But they call this the reaction coordinate. It's really just time. What you start with, here's our reactants A, B. They actually would be situated somewhere over here where we start. And at the end of the reaction, you have CD. And at the end of the reaction, it's down here. So what happens is AB turns into CD, and they go through this potential energy change. So what's happening here, we're going to just label everything. This arrow right here is going to represent the potential energy of the reactants. And since CD are the products, this arrow right here is going to represent the potential energy of the products. Now, there's something called the activation energy. That's to take us from where the reactants start to the top of this hill. This hill right here represents the highest energy state that the reaction has before the complete transition from the reactants to the products. All the atoms are kind of attached. It's about to change, but it hasn't, and that's the high energy state. So to go from here to here, this arrow, the head of this arrow, represents what we call the activation energy. There's also something called reverse activation energy, and that's if we're going to run this reaction backwards. So it's the energy to go from where the products are to the top of this hill. So it's kind of like riding a roller coaster in reverse. In order to start the roller coaster, you have to get to the top of the hill. So going reverse, it has to go that way. Going forward, it only has to go this way. This large arrow, the maximum energy, is what they call the activated complex. It's the largest vocabulary word you're going to have, and it's also the largest line. The final energy you're going to have to account for is the enthalpy, or the heat of reaction. And that's also known as delta H. Delta H is the difference between your products and your reactants. So what you do is you draw a line across from the products, you draw a line across from the reactants, and this difference right here is your delta H. So what I like to do is just make it into a big triangle, because delta H is a triangle with an H. So the height of that triangle is the amount of energy that's required for the heat of reaction, or your enthalpy, your delta H. There's a couple things you need to know about this activation energy right here. The larger the activation energy, the harder it is for a reaction to occur. So if the activation energy is small, the reaction goes along very easily. If it's large, it doesn't happen that much. Now, there is one other thing they're going to ask you, and that is what a catalyst does. Well, a catalyst speeds up the reaction without changing the products of the reactants. So it gets you from the reactants to products quicker. So what it does is it actually lowers the activation energy. And when you draw that, make sure you don't touch this line, make sure you don't touch that one. Right, so make this hill into like a little bump, because you're going to have to draw that, especially if you're taking New York State regions. And that's just the basic breakdown of a potential energy diagram. The next video is going to have a more complex version of this with numbers. So before I go, this is an exothermic process. And you can see that because the hill actually drops down. The endothermic one, you're going to see you start at a lower energy and you end up at a higher one. That's the only difference between exo and endothermic. So I hope this helped. If you need the more advanced version of this, watch the next video.